Hello, land flippers. I am Chris Thomas, and this is Land Flipping 101. Every Friday at noon central, I will come in live to answer questions. So like today, who knows where I'll be located? Today I'm visiting family in Kentucky, and that's one of the things I love about this work. It gives me the location freedom that I want so I can be where I want to be and not be tied to my office. I do have a closing today, and I don't have to go into the office. I can sign for it remotely, so I'm excited about that. Today's deal is a 9-acre property in Tennessee, and I will use my home equity line of credit to purchase the property for $20,000. And on Monday, I'm going to close with an end buyer for $50,000, praying that all goes as planned, because it can change from moment to moment. All right, so go ahead and pop any questions you have into the chat thread, and I'll try to get you an answer today. I was planning on answering a few questions that were already posted in this group. I'll be telling you about my approach and my primary focus in the land business, and I'll give you the script for how to answer the perk test question that everyone has. I'll discuss how I pick a county and an area to mail, and then I'll answer a follow-up question from last week about how I use Facebook Marketplace advertising for my land deals. Also, thank you, Claudette, for congrats. If you have, or if you need any help moving forward in your land investing business, you can schedule a free 15-minute meeting with me over Zoom. Just look for the Calendly link in the announcement at the top of this Facebook group's page. And the land investing business, I will say, is just, it's very doable. There's not much competition, and there is a lot of land out there. You can do this, and I will help you. So let's move your land investing business forward today. So first, I like to talk about in market news, what's going on in the market. And I like to look at Realtor.com and Zillow Research for the state of the market. The housing market does remain strong, which is good for land investors. New home listings are down 7%. Total listings are down 54% compared to last year. And the days on market keep going down year over year, which means that the supply side of the business is low, which would follow. And also the data does show that prices are up 17% year over year. Now, anytime you want to look at accurate market data, you can just go to Zillow Market Plus or just Google search Realtor.com, real estate news, or something like that. Those are the two websites I go to for data and research on what's happening in the market. I saw in March it said there was a good jobs report, 1 million new jobs for the month and tons of construction jobs. So you may be wondering, like I have been, you know, when will the forbearance wave hit? You know, when forbearance stops, it was predicted that many people could potentially lose their house. It was supposed to affect like 5 million homeowners. But now it seems there's only about 5% of homeowners in forbearance right now. And it's probably only going to affect about, if they said on the low end, 50,000, on the high end, maybe 200,000 homeowners. But I really think our banking industry learned from 10 years ago when we had a problem before, and they found ways to fix the problems that forbearance was feared to be causing. So that's good news. I mean, up to 200,000 homeowners will be affected, but that's really not that many when you think about how many there are in this country. They say right now, I think I said 5% of all mortgages are under foreclosure, but they're being addressed and reworked. So people can stay in their homes, and that is great news all around. That's what we want. And today, I really just want to encourage you, if you're just starting out in land investing or you're exploring how to do it, you should know that it is very doable. There are a lot of steps, but if you can stay organized and consistent, you can be successful in this business. You can decide how much you're going to make. It's really just math. Choose what you want to earn and then just reverse engineer your goals. And if you have questions about how to do that, send me a private message or even drop it in the chat and I'll put it out there for everyone to see later. Then, you know, after you get your first deal, just know this. If you can make a profit doing this one time, then you can make a profit doing this over and over again. It's really about organization and consistent daily action. So, all right, let's get to the questions. And then when I go through the questions, I'll come back to the chat and see if you have any other. I see, Andrea, you added something. I think I'll be answering this in my response coming up. But if you still have questions, just drop them in there. And thanks, you all, for being here. So Jerry Mason asked, what primarily is your focus when it comes to identifying potential land buys? For example, are you focused mainly on smaller building lots or anything you think you can profit on? Well, Jerry, thanks for your question. While I know how to flip smaller building lots, which I call infill lots, they're the developed areas where there are like one to two empty lots in a neighborhood. You can more easily price this type of property by looking at the past 12 months at who purchased and sold property in that time period, and then you can see what they paid. If you can identify them as a builder or a flipper and see what they paid and then know what they paid or what they sold it for, then you can sort of back into what your target buy price would be for that area. Zip code would be a good way to look at that. However, I personally focus on rural vacant land, at least 5 or more acres, within a couple of hours outside of a large metro area, and usually in the direction the growth is moving for that city. And then Jerry also asked me, please expound on decisions made when a parcel does not sell after the contract is up, assuming you cannot get an extension. Do you buy anyway with the intention of selling eventually, or will this soak up too much capital? Well, actually, this just happened to me, so it's timely to talk about it. I had a 25-acre parcel that was landlocked. It had a legally deeded easement, but no road access. Legally, a driveway was going to go in eventually. It was a legal fact. However, the neighbors were a bit hostile, and I needed more time to either get a survey or file a lawsuit for access by necessity. So when the contract expired, I ended up just taking it off the market. I could have purchased it, and it probably would have been profitable if I did purchase it. I think the buy price was like $63,000 for 25 acres. But this is really not my business model. I'm not trying to buy property to subdivide it. That can take a long time. It's red tape with the government. My personal strategy is not to risk too much. I tend to be lazy and adverse to risk. So I probably should have wholesaled it to someone else. But I do like to say, we must stay flexible because we can learn something new with every deal. So I hope that helps, Jerry. And if it doesn't, feel free to private message me or post a question in the chat or on the Land Flipping 101 page, discussion page. Okay, so Rachel Osborne asks, if a lot has not had a perk test, can you find buyers or is it recommended that you get one done before marketing? For those of you that don't know what a perk test is, it's basically just checking to see if a traditional septic tank can be installed underground. And while a perk test is certainly advantageous in a situation where you cannot access city sewer, and it's advantageous in that it immediately increases the value of the property because then someone knows, I definitely can put an in-ground system in. So that tells them that they can definitely build a house. But I don't invest in this type of test. My standard response to this question, because it is inevitably asked by everyone looking to purchase my property, I just say we're land investors bringing you land prices at below market value. And as such, we are not builders and we have not invested in any site work. So I hope that helps. Thanks for the question, Rachel. And then Eugene Stee asks, how do you pick a location or an area? And this is probably the most common question that I have been asked. And I boil it down to this. Just look for the fast-growing cities and then look for counties around that city that are in the path of growth. I usually target no less than 30 miles and no more than 200 miles outside of town with at least a 10% growth in population since the last census. And the last census was in 2010. You can check worldpopulationreview.com and target United States and then look at all the states. There's a graph and there's a lot of good information in there about population growth. I also look for a county that has at least 150,000 population because I want to have a good buyer pool for my property. And then I choose 6 to 8 counties to mail blind offers to. I send a letter with an attached purchase agreement, and I mail it to about 2,000 records, 2,000 property owners across 6 to 8 counties. And that usually will get me about 1 to 3 leads. I've personally advanced enough now in my land flipping business that I'm able to send out 2,000 units a week. And I'm looking to increase that because my pipeline's getting really good. I'm starting to hit, consistently hit my goal month after month. Okay, the last thing is, I was hoping Rachel might be watching, and maybe she'll see it later, but last week on the Facebook Live, she was asking about Marketplace and would I create a video. And I haven't done the video because I didn't really want to put my personal page up there, my selling page. So I decided not to do a video, at least not yet. So I did post on the Land Flipping 101 page this morning about Marketplace, and I use it to post ads on all my properties. And I probably have 120 different groups that I post my ads into. But basically, when you sell something on Marketplace, you just create a public listing that can be seen by anyone on Marketplace, and it's also able to be seen in newsfeed and search and other places on or off Facebook. And I target my ad to relevant groups based on a local geographic area, like buy sell groups and land for sale groups. You just use your local town name in the search bar on Facebook Marketplace, and then follow it with the term like land for sale or traders post. Like there's a town in Lebanon, Tennessee called Lebanon Traders Post, I think. So when I had a piece of property in that area, I posted it there. There was like 40,000 people in that group. I got a ton of response. You could also type in, you know, Lebanon real estate investment, or I live in Nashville, so Nashville real estate investment. You can find the investor groups that way, and always post your land in all those types of local groups. It doesn't have to be a real estate group or a land group. It could be any kind of buy-sell group or trading type of page. And then I also put in some of the instructions specifically on how and where to put your ad up on Marketplace. So you just look in the announcement, or not the announcement, but the news feed on the Land Flipping 101 page, and there are step-by-step instructions on how to create your Facebook ad. So first you have to go in though and join those relevant groups before you can post into them. So that could be the first step. You go in and join, you know, Lebanon and Land for Sale. And then, or Lebanon Traders Post, whatever it's called, they have different names. Just sort of use your Google search bar and then click on groups, and it'll bring up stuff in that local area. So you join those first, and then you create your ad, and then it allows you to post your ad into that group. Just make sure you're following the group rules. Sometimes I get blocked or I get turned away, but that's just part of it. It's pretty intuitive once you get in there. Okay, well, that's really all I have prepared for today. I thank you for watching. Reach out to me with a personal message if you get stuck. You can do this, and I'll be glad to help. All right, have a good weekend. Bye-bye.